Leopoldo Gonzalez, Torres, born November 15, 1920. As a young man growing in Guanajuato, Mexico, Leopoldo tried to work for his father, a carpenter. But father and son proved an explosive mix. He used to say his father was too much of a perfectionist when it came to working with wood. Instead, he went into the shoemaking business, showing that he was just as good with leather as his father was with wood. Leopoldo started making lady shoes in factories of León, Mexico. León is said to be to shoes what New York is to finance and what Hollywood is to the film industry. It's where you go to find the latest in shoes, boots, and leather. It was in León where Leopoldo met Josefa, his wife, and began making a family. When he died in 2005, he had 14 children, 33 grandchildren, and 9 great-grandchildren. They later moved to Matamoros and went to work for Abraham Rios. In 1961, Mr. Rios moved his company to Raymondville, and the Torres family followed. Leopoldo was always looking for a better way of life for his family, and this is just it. Part of it included school. The Torres family always had a strong emphasis on education. It didn't matter what he had to do, if he had to borrow money, my abuelo made sure they had what they needed for school. Work at the boot factory wasn't enough to support 14 children. So when summer came, the family migrated to California to pick in the onion field. The last year they went, it was the same year Cesar Chavez began his boycott. Leopoldo assured his children that if they didn't want to pick onions for the rest of their lives, they needed to continue school, and they did just that. All 14 children got some sort of higher education. Back in Raymondville, Leopoldo was gaining a reputation for himself, and he began making boots at night for his own clients. In 1971, Leopoldo went out of his own and opened Torres Boot Company. Out of 14 children, half of them picked up the bootmaking process, but all were involved in the company one way or another. For 27 years. Despite advances in machinery, the company kept making boots by hand. About as automated as he got was the NEC register. Leopoldo kept strict standards for himself and all his workers, relatives or not. Josefa kept up with all the kids despite suffering from polio, but there were some things she just couldn't do. News of his skills spread and Leopoldo began getting famous clients. He made boots for President Ronald Reagan and polo boots for Prince Charles. Leopoldo measured every foot at the Raymondville factory. He couldn't have had a lot more money except for one thing. My abuelo wouldn't fly. Some of the wealthier clients didn't have time to come to Raymondville and wanted to send their private jets for him. My abuelo said that if God wanted us to fly, he would have given us wings. In 1990, my abuelo closed doors to his shop due to the struggle he had with off-the-rack boots. People weren't willing to pay for quality. Leopoldo was a family man, and he enjoyed spending time with his family, so he began to enjoy life. As young girls, my sisters and I enjoyed going over to Willow's house and working in his garage/part-time bootmaking company. Even though he closed the doors to the boot company, he continued to make boots out of his home in Raymondville. My sisters and I enjoyed cleaning his shop. If it were picking up nails with a large magnet or putting his boots in size order, we had fun. My abuelo enjoyed hunting when in season, and we would have to take the RV to take my abuela that was bedridden because he wouldn't go anywhere without her. We always enjoyed being his bird dogs and plucking those birds so we could eat after a hard day's work. On May 16, 2005, my abuela was admitted to Valley Baptist Medical Center and was told he wasn't going home. It was only 6 months after the loss of his wife that my abuelo died. He held on while we were in his room reminiscing of all the good times. But we were all new, and he was ready to join his wife in heaven. My abuelo had a big heart and helped everyone in any way that he could. He died on May 17, 2005. Today I am proud to say that my abuelo was born in Guanajuato, Mexico, came to Raymondville for a better life, and accomplished many great things, and continues to be a well-known master craftsman who made boots for royalty.